Hey guys, Dr. Chris here from Accrue Health. We got another great lunch to learn this week for you guys. And I want to teach you guys an important principle about how mental, emotional, and chemical stresses on your body actually impact your spine and your nervous system. See, most of you guys, when you guys learn about the impact of stress on the body and how it impacts your spine, the number one place you guys all originally think about is the physical stresses of your life. You guys think about, oh, it was my workout yesterday. It was the way I was sitting in my desk chair for hours, the way I was sleeping last night, the posture that I was in. We think about all these physical stresses and we think that that's what caused us to, quote, get out of adjustment, right? Or get out of alignment. But the reality is that if I had to distill it down or break it down, it's actually the physical stresses that have the least amount of impact on our body every single day. It's really way, way, way more commonly the mental, emotional stresses of our work, our life, our finances, the stress of the news, what's going on in politics, what's going on, all these different things that cause us stress and overwhelming anxiety every single day. Now, you might wonder why the heck I'm standing in front of a breaker box here. And the reality is that this is maybe one of the single best analogies or ways to understand why stress impacts your nervous system and your spine. See, if you ever thought about this, why does a breaker switch actually flip off? What causes one of these switches on its own without anybody touching it to flip to the other side, right? If you're thinking overload or overwhelm, you're absolutely correct. See, what happens is that the breaker box in this whole system is actually almost a safety that's built into the entire electrical framework of this office. And if there's overload on the system, what it'll do is the breaker switch will flip as a response to that overload, so it doesn't shut down the entire electrical system in the office here, okay? And the same thing applies to your house or to your apartment or whatever it is. Now, here's the thing. In our body, it's the same type of a thing. A lot of times these subluxations that we discuss, it's because your body is actually subluxating itself as a response to overload and stress and overwhelm. Okay, does that make sense? See, the reality is if this breaker switch flips off, it might affect something in an office or in one of the rooms across the office, or where the computers are, or where the TV is. And if I don't understand electricity, how this is connected to any of that makes no sense. But if I know that all of those come back to specific places on this, and if I find that's off and I flip it back on, immediately we're gonna have proper function restored to those other places. And so the same thing happens in your body. A lot of times where we feel pain, where we have different issues in our digestive system, in our thyroid leading to headaches, or these different things that are going on, it's because there's issues going back from stress in our life that's impacting that spine and nervous system and leading things to start shutting off or not functioning and communicating the same way. So next time you think about how your spine and nervous system is impacted by stress, yes, it's very possible that it could have been how you slept last night, or the computer posture, or the phone posture, all these different things. But more likely, it was the mental emotional stress you've been dealing with that we all deal with. And how do we help better overcome that? It's by making sure that we're helping navigate these stresses effectively on a daily basis. Again, I'm Dr. Chris. I hope this helped you guys better understand your nervous system and spine and stress. And I hope you never look at one of these the same again. Thanks.